Hello and welcome back to the Gusek tutorial for beginners. In this video, we are going to start talking about printf. So grab a mug of coffee and let us get started. This tutorial will teach you three different ways to print a result on Gusek's terminal. First, you learn to display the results in a format similar to a table. Then, based on the acquired knowledge, we will print the results in a simplified statement. And finally, we are going to advance and include an if clause in the print statement. In the previous videos, we were printing the results using the function display, and the values were shown in an ugly format, as you see on your screen. In this section, I will teach you to display the results in a tabular form. Let's go back to our code and erase the display statement on line 24. I would like you to write printf space quotation mark backslash n quotation mark and semicolon. The text within the quotation mark is what Gusek will print at the terminal. The backslash n tells Gusek to go to the next line. Inside the quotation marks, type backslash n results backslash n. Compile and run the code. Do you see that the word result is now appearing at the terminal? That's what we want. Let's set the line between the word result and the values. To do so, type printf, then add a bunch of dashes and finish with backslash n inside quotation marks. Don't forget to add a semicolon in the end of the line. The next step is to create the table. Type printf and within quotation marks write from, add 2 spaces, to, 3 spaces, units, backslash n, and semicolon. Let's compile and see what it looks like. Cool, we started to structure our table. Let's add one column at a time. The first column is under the word from and must include the suppliers A and B. Write printf keys I in S keys quotation mark percentage S backslash N quotation mark comma I semicolon. This piece of code states that I is in set S, which in our case contain elements A and B. Note that where we wrote percentage S, Gusek will replace with the suppliers I. If the suppliers were labeled as numbers, then you would have to use percentage G. If you compile and run the code, you see that the suppliers A and B are under the column from. The next step consists in adding J under the column to. Inside the keys in the printf statement, include comma J in C. Also, inside the quotation marks, add percentage G before backslash N, and additionally, type comma J before the semicolon. Let's run the model and see the print statement. Oh no, the customer's IDs are under the word from. We need to fix this. Let's go back to the printf that we were working. Before letter G, add a number 6. This number indicates the space between percentage G and percentage S. If you try to run the code again, you see that the customers are now under column 2. The final column requires the number of units shipped from supplier I to customer J. Recall that this is the value of the decision variable X. Let's update the printf one more time. Type another percentage G inside the quotation marks and before the backslash N. Also, add comma X brackets IJ before the semicolon. As you can see, the number of products is not under the column of units. Let's add the number 6 before both letters G and run the model. Great. Now that we have a table, we should print the total cost. Write printf, quotation mark, the total cost is, dollar sign, percentage g, backslash n, quotation mark, comma, cost, semicolon. Rerun the model, and voila! We are displaying the results in a user-friendly format. Now that you have printed the result in a tabular format, let's rewrite it differently. In this new format, we want to print a sentence that says how much each supplier will deliver to each customer. Return to our model. Start by erasing the previous printf statements. Instead of writing results and adding a line, type printf, quotation marks, backslash n, 5-, result, 5-, backslash n, quotation marks, semicolon. Try to run the code and see if you notice anything different. In this new version, the results are in a bluish color. This is helpful to identify the results location within all the text in the terminal. On the next line, write printf keys I in S, comma J in C, quotation mark, supplier percentage S, ships percentage G, products to customer percentage G, backslash N, quotation mark, comma, I, X brackets IJ, J, semicolon. Observe that the order of the outputs after the comma is the same as the one in the percentage. Let's add the total cost statement, as we constructed in the previous section, and run the code. Great, now you know two different ways to display the results. Let's move to the final section and write a more advanced way to display the results. Do you see that some variables have a final value of 0? In this new version, we are going to print only the positive values. Start erasing the printf statement of the previous version, except for the objective function statement. Nice. Type printf keys I in S, comma J in C keys. Now, this is the part when we add the if statement to inform that only values greater than 0 must be printed. Write parenthesis if x brackets I, comma j brackets less than or equal 0, then two quotation marks. These marks are empty because nothing will be printed if the value is 0. Following, type else, quotation mark, supplier, percentage S, ships to percentage G, a total of percentage G, units, backslash N, and close parenthesis. Continue typing comma, I, J, XIJ, semicolon. If you run the model, you print the results only for the positive variables, as you see on the terminal. Before we conclude this tutorial, let's do one more thing. Inside the quotation marks, after the else statement, write percentage S to percentage G equals percentage G. Run the code again, and you get a cleaner way to display the results. I hope you are able to successfully print your results on the terminal. If you want to practice more, visit my webpage, luanaalmeida.com, where you can find many exercises with examples. That's it! Stay tuned to the upcoming tutorials on GooseX.